Hi everyone, welcome to Border Tax with Stewie JP. I'm Stewie, you're not, and either this bloke, this is Cy91 from Calm Clan. Cy91, been a big supporter of this channel for a long time. He is in the STB-1, the Tier 10 Japanese medium tank. Now, this is a tank that I have not had much luck with at all. I don't think it's any secret. It's just one of those tanks. I haven't played many games in it, though, to be fair. So, who knows? Maybe I'll come good one day. Anyway, Cy91's platooned up with his old mate. Results may vary from Cat Clan and is on. What's this one called? Melanovka is going up to the top of the hill where all the action seems to happen. He finds the Batchat 25T, who looks like he's clipping someone out. Puts a shot into the 50B, pulls back, because that 50B is an autoloader as well, so he needs to be a little bit careful. Waits for the gun to reload. You can see he's got Japanese food on Giri for a 10% bonus to all crew skills and perks. APCR rounds are standard. 105mm gun, 390 damage, 258 penetration, 330 with heat rounds. Now, I believe that the STB-1 has one of the higher damage per minute guns in the game. I'm sure somebody will correct me if I'm wrong. The 50B looks like the 50B getting shot by his platoon mate as well. He blocks a shot from the 110. Of course, this is a tier 10 game, but only three tier 10 tanks on each team. And Cy91's team is winning at the moment. Looking at that IS-3, who's in a pretty good hold down position, even though he is in a tier 10 battle. Puts a shot into the 50B, and that 50B just moving out, so Cy91 can just farm some damage into the Tier 10 auto-loading French heavy tank. One zip, two zips to score now as the 50B goes down to the T95. And he looks at that. E4 looks a little bit precarious. He bounces the turret of the American tank destroyer and that pulls back. He doesn't want to get hit by that big American gun. Bounces the tier 8, German heavy as well. 2,786 damage done, 1,100 damage blocked. He puts a shot into the top of the turret. He bounces another shot from the VK. Block damage up to 1,400 hit points as he shoots the AMX M449. Premium French heavy tank. 4 zip is the score. Looking at getting some more damage, up to nearly 4,000 hit points of damage. Of course, this is going to be a double shot of French action. And the next one, French, Japanese STB-1 action. The next one will feature my old mate Bolognese from Team Efficiency. Running around in this Japanese medium tank. Have a look at it. It's pretty flat. Maybe that's what makes it pretty good. Cy91 picks up his first kill, getting rid of the IS-3, and he's just having this continues just to move around and have a look at these enemy tanks. That shot goes a little bit wide. The shot towards the defender, I think it was, and he's just keeping this gun working, poking over this ridge line, looking at shooting all these bad boys. The score's 9-2. It's fast and furious. Already done 5,000 damage. 1,420 damage blocked. And 1,279 assisted damage. And looking at the back of this AMX M449, Object 252 used the last tank remaining on the enemy team up here. He wants to get some of that action. Shoots him for 360. Brings his damage up to 5,800. He's having a ripper. The T-32's getting in on the action. Calm says, hang on, I've only got one kill. Let's make it two so he can keep up with his platoon mate in the T-110E5. Looks like the 704 has been tracked. He snipes a shot for 367 damage into the T-9 Russian tank destroyer. Who finally goes down to the Stritzwagen. I thought that would have happened a little bit quicker. He's still got 1,184 hit points up his sleeve. He has been spotted. Wants to be a little bit careful of that T-95, but it doesn't matter because the Object 430 Mark II picks up the kill on the Doom Turtle, and Cy91 from Khan continues to roll forward on 6,308 hit points of damage. He's looking for that artillery, the Ray 155-51. He will be a little bit nervous, that's for sure. Let's see if we can find him. There he is. That makes three kills, and that way he can stick it up his platoon mate and say, there you go, I got three and you only got two. Not a bad result at all for me old mate Cy91 from Calm. Cy91 picking himself up an Ace Tanker Mastery Badge in the Tier 10 Japanese medium tank. the STB-1. He also got himself a Bruiser Medal, Fire for Effect, Confederate for shooting more enemy tanks than anyone else, and the High Caliber. Had plenty to do with the demise of all these tanks on the right-hand side of the screen. And topped the score charts with 6,411 damage, 3 kills, 1,209 base experience. His platoon mate didn't do too badly at all with nearly 5,000 damage. And Psy-91 a bit high-fiving all the way. He fired 23 shots, 21 hit, 18 did damage, 6,411. Only one shot from a distance of more than 300 metres by the looks of it. 1,617 assisted damage in that game that went for just 4.5 minutes. Made 14,500 credits. That's with a standard account. Would have been 45 with a premium account. Even though he was running Japanese food, for that cost him 10,000. Clearly that was on sale when that happened. Not a bad result at all for Psy-91 from Calm Clan. As we move on to the second battle in this double shot of tier 10 Japanese medium tank action, this is my old mate TE Bolognese, Team Efficiency Bolognese from Pyro Clan in the STB-1, the same tank. And have a look at this, he's got two marks of excellence on that gun barrel. And well, let's see if he can improve on that one. Same as Psy-91's game, three tier 10 tanks on each team, the T110E5, the T62A, and the Grill on the enemy team, and Bolognese in the STB-1. The Object 260 and the FV215B183 on Bolognese's team. And look at the mini-map. Bolognese has put in the chat at the start, let's go this way, let's smash it, and we'll win. And it looks like everybody's listened. Batchat 12T, nothing wrong with what he's doing out there, getting a little bit of vision out in the northwest. Even if he finds something such as the Hawk, if he finds a little bit more out here, then Bolognese and the rest of the team will know that they have a numerical advantage in the south. But Bolognese looking for his first kill, takes the baby Batchat down to absolutely stuff all health, decides to put a shot into the RU-251, and why wouldn't you? 1230 damage done already. The RU-251 goes down to the baby Batchat on Bolognese's team, who's picked up both of the kills. And Bolognese not stuffing around here, he's getting stuck straight up here, getting some vision for his team, and he's going to start chipping away at these tanks. Shoots T-30 for 348 hit points. Just pulling back, just trying to bait some of these tanks over, give his teammates a chance to do a little bit of damage. Fires towards the Emil, doesn't quite land the shot. 2-1's the score, he's already up to 1578 damage, he's got a bit of assisted damage there as well. Just working this ridgeline like an absolute legend in the Japanese tier 10 medium tank, the STB-1. Just looking at the T110E5, looks like the T-175 just fired there. He might get the chance to put a shot in. He does. You can see he's got heat loaded. And, of course, he's been, from what I can gather, from what I've seen on his live stream as well as the replays he's been sending me, he's been trying to three-mark a few tanks, and he's certainly doing very, very well. Chipping away at the T-110E5. That T-110E5 won't know what hit him. Who was that? No, that was a teammate. That's okay. 3-1's a score. One shot left to kill the T-110E5. He sees the Grill low, doesn't want to lose too much health too early on. The T-125 is just waiting to be killed, and that's what Bolognese does, gets rid of one of the three tier 10 tanks on the enemy team. T-62A, I reckon the T-62A will be his next target on just 804 hit points. The T-30 and the Grill are in the background, and that's what Bolognese is being a little bit careful about. Cops a shot from the Grill for 846 damage. If he gets another shot from that Grill, he's dead. It's as simple as that. He's down to 791 hit points, and that's why he's been a little bit conservative, I guess you would say, even though he's right at the front line, just poking, because all those tank destroyers on the mini-map, as well as the Guard and the Emil, sniping like absolute champions from back there. 5-2's a score. Bolognese from Team Efficiency and Pyro Clan on 3,762 damage. 929 assisted damage. He's not camping the red line. Don't worry about that. He's right up the front where all the action happens, putting damage into these enemy tanks and providing some vision as well. You can see the Emil 2, or the Emil 1 at tier 8, sorry, has jumped on the other side of the railway line and just picked up the kill on that LTTB who was out here in the water. The Batchat 12T still trying to spot from over here what tanks, the only tanks that have not yet been spotted are the two artilleries and the Chinese tier 8 tank destroyer, the WZ-120 1FT. And so maybe it'd be worthwhile this guy coming over forward. Who knows? 5-4 is the score. A couple of tanks have just been taken down. 5-5 the score now. So Bolognese wants to... He's going to have to do it all by himself by the looks of things. He's up. He's on one kill, 4,152 hit points. He just shot the T-30, the T-9 American tank destroyer. Artillery put some pain into it. Just picked up another 500 assisted damage into the grill. Possibly from artillery as well. I can't see where that grill is. You can see the Scorpion G there. Looks like he's still stunned as well. Artillery chipping away at those tank destroyers. Bolognese recognising the T-62A. That's probably the one they want to get rid of. That T-62A is keeping a lot of these tanks lit up. And I'm a little bit surprised enemy artillery has not been dropping too many turds in Bolognese's direction. The Batchat 12T light tank and the TAP Baby Batchat medium tank here, clearly trying to do something about this WZ-120, who looks like he's on a bit of an arty run. And that artillery back at the base, he'll be a little bit nervous and hoping that they can clean him up. Anyway, back to Bolognese's point of view. 4,152 hit points of damage, 1,626 assisted damage so far, but he is just warming up. T30 on 18 hit points. I don't think the T30's got a shot on Bolognese there, but Bolognese doing the right thing and being very careful about poking over, because that grill is still back there and it's not lit. And of course, if that grill shoots him, like I said earlier, on 791 hit points, last time the grill hit him, it took him for 846, so that would be enough to be out of there. But it doesn't mean he's not going backwards. He's still staying in the front lines, keeping vision towards these enemy tanks. It looks like the E-75 and someone else is running as if their life depends on it. It looks like all these tanks are just running away at the moment. Six all though is still the score. I'm very surprised that the enemy team are running so convincingly. They're only down by one tank, and who knows? 7-6. There's that E. I can see why the E-75 has been running away. He bounces the grill for 750 hit points. That's how you do it. He'll be going, fucking hell. Didn't think that was going to happen. 7-all, he's up to nearly 5,000 damage. He's got a little bit more to do, though, if he's going to carry this game. That grill still not spotted. I think he might be right back there in a similar position to where the Scorpion G might be. Bolognese just working off this ridgeline very, very nicely. There's a lot of low health tanks, though. There's that grill. He wants to get that grill. He doesn't want that grill to get the opportunity to kill him. Everything else, he can sort of take advantage a little bit later. Gets the grill again. Takes him down to 515 hit points. But unfortunately, there's nobody close enough to spot the grill, and I think Bolognese would probably be a little bit concerned that the Emil or the T-30 might be able to get vision on him if he stays up here. That Emil, I cannot believe how long that Emil has stayed alive for. On 75 hit points. Ooh, looks like artillery tried to get him, but not quite, not this time. Anyway, 9-all's the score. You can see the Batchat 12T running around here now. Now, this is letting Bolognese and the team know that there's nothing else up here. Everything else is down here, even though the two artilleries have not been lit. Clearly, they're not going to be up there. So now Bolognese can probably come around here and get the kill shot on that Emil 1. Not sure where that T-30 is. That T-30 could be on either side of the railway line. You can see the STI, T-10 and the FV on Bolognese's team having a nice push down there. Finally, the Emil goes down and Bolognese picks up his second kill. Brings his damage up to nearly 5,500. There's that grill again. He's just looking for it. Is he going to pump a blind shot in? No, he's not. He does need to be careful. He's a one shot for the grill. Maybe a one shot for the T-30. I think the T-30's got about a 750 alpha damage gun from memory. So a high roll on the T-30 might kill Bolognese, but I very much doubt it. He's looking at that FV saying, "You beauty." Puts a shot into the British T-9 artillery piece. Takes him down to a one shot. And he's clearly going for the damage. Puts a shot into the GW Tiger P. Brings his damage count to over 6,000. He does get spotted. The grill is still in play, but the grill as well as the Scorpion G behind that ridgeline. So Bolognese continuing to move forward, not stuffing around here. He wants to three mark this tank, and he reckons he's probably pretty close. The nerves are probably starting to play in here. Looking at the Scorpion G, just wants a couple more shots. He missed the shot into the Scorpion G. Somebody else hits a grill for 450 hit points, and there's still 1,000 hit points up for grabs on the Scorpion. He'll take the 65 into the grill to get rid of that tier 10 gun, and now he knows he can go straight towards that grill on 851 health. Of course, that grill would take two shots to kill Bolognese. He's up to 6,245. He's blocked a little bit. He's got plenty of assisted damage. He'd love to get one more shot and maybe even a fourth kill. But let's see how he goes. Looks like he's charging straight towards the Scorpion G. You can see that he's not aiming his way. Bolognese picks up the last kill of the game. 6,500 damage going by what he saw in there. And he'll be pretty happy with that performance. Not only will he be happy with that performance, he'll be high-fiving all the way to the bank because he three-marked that tank in that battle, the STB-1. A tier 10 Japanese medium tank, three marks of excellence. That is absolutely magnificent. An ace tanker, bruiser, fighter, fire for effect, confederate for shooting more enemy tanks than anyone else. I think he shot just about all of them. And of course, that high caliber medal for carrying the shit out of it. 6,500 damage, four kills, 1282 base experience. He fired 34 shots, 23 hit, 19 did damage. That might not sound too accurate, but of course, there's some of those shots he didn't have much to aim at. And of course, you've got to take those shots as well. If every now and then you're going to land a few, so you might as well go for it. 1626 assisted damage. Ace Tanker Mastery Badge, you beauty. Did more than double what anyone else did damage-wise in that entire game. A well-deserved ace and three marks of excellence. That's absolutely massive. Yes, it cost him some credits, but running plenty of premium ammunition as well as... He must have bought a heap of consumables at half price because it didn't get charged for the consumables, but obviously premium ammo in the medium tank. Clearly not very cheap, but well worth it. Three marks of excellence in the STB. That is absolutely enormous. Well done, Bolognese. Don't forget to check him out on Twitch. Link will be down there somewhere, along with all the other stuff, like, you know, whatever else might be there. Once again, thanks for the replays. Cy91 from Calm Clan and Bolognese. Absolutely epic. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take care. See you all next time.